Summer Teacher 7, Mr. Barry here. Today I want to talk about Google Docs and really how it compares to Microsoft Office, and is Google Docs even useful, or you know, how to use it and all the features that are found in it. Now this is not a end-all video. That means it's not going to be that long. I have special videos that go into all of the features of Google Docs and even Microsoft Office. You just go to my channel and there's a playlist. It's called Computer Literacy. And the computer literacy classes go into using Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google everything, Google all the Google apps, Google Photos, for example. And they really go into detail. And it's usually a 16-part series. And that would be part of my regular instruction that I actually use in my classroom. So I'm a teacher. I work with Selma Unified School District, as well as Kings Canyon Unified School District, and I teach the same classes to adults and also to the staff. So I'm working with teachers and other members of the staff there with using and getting the most out of Google Docs and all the other applications that we are allowed to use there in the districts. Everyone has a Chromebook, so we're all doing everything with Chromebooks, and that makes everything very easy to really get into because everyone knows their username and their password. And I'm often getting questions such as, well, can I use Chromebooks offline? And the answer is yes. And I actually have a video on that, but I can show you how to do that. So I can show you today that. I can also show you some of the other things of like how useful Google Docs is. Let me get going with that and show you how I use it in creating all my lessons and everything else. So if you're looking for just installing and using Microsoft Word on your Chromebook, you can skip ahead to about 14 minutes into the video. We'll actually show you where in the web store to find it and install it on your Chromebook. I also go into how the two applications differ in their UI and usability. So right now I'm going to look at the features found in Google Docs. Okay, now to start, you just simply go to google.com, and your page will probably be either white or gray in the background, but I'm using a theme, so that's why you see Mars here. And then you go over here to the upper right-hand corner, and you find new Google Apps. Click on Google Apps, and you can find many different apps there. Now, you can actually have Google Docs found here, but let's just say that you don't see it here. Go to Google Drive. And once you get to your Google Drive, you notice that you can find more applications if you click on New. You have Google Docs, Google Sheets, Google Slides, and even more stuff can be found there. You can even connect to more apps if you don't see the app that you like to use. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to go to click on New, and then we're going to go Google Docs. And I can actually create a new document there. Just to let you know, once you do have documents stored here in your Google Drive, you can right-click any of them and then say make available offline. You click that right there, and then that will make those particular docs usable offline. So what we're going to do is we're going to go into New, and I'll just create a new blank one here. Now, one of the things I like to do normally at the beginning is name my document. So I'm going to call this one Google Doc Features. So now it's saved the document in my Google Drive. If anything happens to my computer, such as it goes down, well, don't worry. Your Google document is already saved in your drive. Simply go back to your Google Drive with another computer, and there's your work. Nothing has been lost. And I want to show you some things here. First off is File. So you can share the document with others. You can create new documents from there. You can open existing work. You can make a copy, so if you have different versions of it, you can do that. You can actually download it. So if you're still in an office or someplace where people are sharing Microsoft Word documents and you need to send it as a Microsoft Word, well, sure, go ahead. Download it as a Microsoft Word document, but you also have PDF, which is really common as well. Next, you can email it as an attachment, so send it to someone as an email. And you can make available offline. There's that option again. You have the version history. Now, this is really a nice feature found in Google Docs, where let's say that you're making changes to your document and you're doing it over many sessions. That means many days or weeks. You can actually go back and look at an earlier version of your document. You don't have to manually save it. You don't have to tell it to do this. The computer is automatically doing it for you. So let's say that you made some changes a week ago. You can actually go back and look at your version history right here and then see it, what it was on that week or on that day, and undo specific changes, such as undo a deleted paragraph or something like that. You can rename it from here, move it to a different folder in your Google Drive, and as I already said earlier, you can download it onto your hard drive. You can delete it by moving it to trash. You can actually publish it. So if you're doing a book or something like that and you need to publish it to the web, that's an easy way to do that, where you can actually publish it to Amazon and other places. You have document details, such as if you're doing this for a class, maybe in college, you have to know how many words are in your letter or in your document. Sure, go ahead and look at document details, and those types of things can be found there. You can change the language of the document so that the spell check is in the language that you're using. So if I was doing everything in Spanish, I can change it to Spanish, and then it'll bring up the dictionary and other language features there for that language. So right now I'm using United States English. I have page setup, and that's where I'm allowed to change the orientation, make it portrait or landscape. I can change my margins. I have the paper size, so if I was using specially sized paper, I could change it, even change the page color. After you made your changes, you click on OK, and then you are back into your document. Let's go here, and I can print up my document as well. So yes, you are able to print from your Chromebook. And all you have to do is register your printer with your Google account. And I do have step-by-step instructions on how to do that within my YouTube channel. Just simply go to my channel and do a search under printer, and you'll be able to find those videos on how to set up your printer with your Google account. Let's look at some other things here. I can have the undo, so if I make a mistake, I can undo it, redo it, copy paste. I can do a lot of things there with that. I can change my view. Under insert, I can insert an image. I can even edit the image once I have it in my document as well. I can insert tables, a drawing. A drawing is basically like if I want to do in word art. So if I go here and I go word art, and I just call it word art here, and enter, and there's my word art. I can then make changes to that word art, change the color to anything I need it to be, change the outline there, that's the border. There we go. I can change my fonts for that. Once I'm happy with the way that I like it there, I just click on save and close, and there it is. And I can resize it once I'm there. And I can move it to where I want it to be simply by changing the wrapping styles. And these are the wrapping styles down here where you have inline, wrap text, or break text. Under insert, I also have special characters, and other things can be found here, such as page numbers if you're doing a large document for college. Table of contents, I can add that, add a bookmark to get to that area if you have a large book. Under format, I can format my text. I have paragraph styles, alignments, lining, line spacing, columns, so I can have multiple columns in my document. That's one of the newer features that I really enjoy having. Bullets and numbering, headers and footers, page numbers, and so you can change the format of any of those. So under tools, you have spelling and grammar. Now, one of the nice things, it's always checking your spelling and your grammar as you're typing. If it underlines it in red, you have a misspelled there. So if I go in and type in California, but then add a G to the end of it, and continue typing, you notice that it says, hey, something's wrong with this word. You can right click it and say, oh yes, I meant California. Other tools, you have word count, review, suggestion edits, and other things are found here that I actually use quite often. I could translate the document, so I teach the class in Spanish, and it's easy. You just take your document once you finished it, and it's a translate document, and you can put it to any language that you want. You simply choose a language there. There it is, and there's many, many languages, as you can see here, that you can choose from. You click on the one that you want, and it will then convert your document to that language, so translate it. All right, next on our tools, one that I love using is voice typing. So let's go in here and let's click here to the microphone, and you'll be recording, so you have to be careful what you say. Let's click here and do it. Google Docs is wonderful to have on your Chromebook. It's so useful, and it even works offline, period. So there you go, and let's see if it worked here. Google Docs is wonderful to have on your Chromebook. It's so useful, and it even works offline, and there's a period there, so this works perfect. Very, very good. Now, other things that we can have add-ons. Let's just say that you're working with Google Docs, and there is some feature that you're really wanting that you don't see. Just click on add-ons and then simply click on get add-ons, and you can actually find other features can be found there. So there's many, many other features. You can search through those, and it adds usability to your Google Docs. Next is help. You can simply click here and you can actually search what you're looking for, and it'll bring it up. There's training, there's updates, you can actually report problems, and then there's keyboard shortcuts as well. So you can learn all the wonderful keyboard shortcuts too. You do have these menus up here, so your undo, redo, print, spelling and grammar, paint format, and others can be found up here, and I use those often. If you notice that let's say that you don't know what this one does, that B up here, all you do is take your mouse, place it there. If you just hold it there for a second, it says its name, bold. So it's easy to know and use all of this. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go in and click on file. I'm going to open up one of my documents that I've worked with in the past. I'm going to go down and open up lesson number 4 from my computer literacy book. So here's lesson number 4 from my computer literacy course. And I do have this as a video format. We can actually go through the entire chapter, and all you have to do is go to my playlist, go to computer literacy 2019, and then click on lesson number 4, and you can actually see the whole chapter being read out and worked out there step by step. You notice here I have images that I've inserted. It's easy to work with images. As I said earlier, just go to insert image, and find the image that you want to use. Once the image is in there, I can go in and change its size. I can do other things, such as if I double click it, I can crop off certain areas. So if I didn't want myself to be in this, I can actually crop myself off it there and cut parts. We call that cropping. Notice that there's numbering going on with these steps. And that's basically how I do everything with my lesson when I'm teaching in the classroom. And everything has a step order so that everyone knows right where they are in the steps. If you watch my instructional videos, you'll notice that I go into step by step, and this is actually what I use in there. So how does Google Docs compare with Microsoft Word? Within your Chromebook, you are able to go to the Chrome Web Store. Once you're there, just simply type in Microsoft Word, and you can actually find the Microsoft Word app right there as you see on my screen. Go ahead and click on Add to Chrome, and then you'll be added to your Chromebook. So here we have Google Docs on the left-hand side and Microsoft Word over here on the right-hand side. Now, the first thing that you notice right away is the UI, or the user interface, at the top. They are different. We have banners over for Microsoft Word, whereas we have these menus for Google Docs. They have the same features, believe it or not. We do have WordArt and other features where you can insert tables, insert images, and do other things like that in both applications. One of the nice things is that Google Docs that we see here is totally free. And if I wanted to, I can click on add-ons and find more applications or more features to add on and include into my application. Whereas Microsoft Word, if I wanted to add more, I would have to go to what's called Go Premium, and then I have to pay Microsoft a yearly subscription or a monthly subscription, depending on which I want to use, to Go Premium and have all those extra features there. For me, I'm just going to go with the free version of Google Drive here in Google Docs and have all the features for free. Another caveat of using a Chromebook with Google Docs is there's no limit on how many documents that you can actually store in your Google Drive, as long as you're using Google Docs to create them. In this video, I've gone over the features that we find in Google Docs and compared it to Microsoft Office. Now, this is just a really surface looking at it, just really at a glance. If you want more detail, I do have videos that go into the features in depth, and that's part of my computer literacy playlist. I recommend that you go in there and watch those. Please give it a thumbs up, share the videos, and thank you very much. Bye-bye.